Okay, come in.
Hi. Hi, my name is Glinder.
Okay, may I see your resume?
That's my resume.
Okay, so my name is Ronald Fenn. I'm your interviewer for this session of interview.
Nice to meet you.
So we'll start this and we just make it relax and don't make it.
Yeah, I'm supposed to do that to have a
Okay, so can you introduce yourself first?
Okay, my name is Gurendra and I'm from Sri Lanka. And I have academic qualifications, like I have done all levels at my school, St. Mary's College at Sri Lanka. And my results were like 1A to 3Bs and 4Cs and 1S. And if any compete myself, I'm so interested in mathematics that I want to become like an engineering student. But like unfortunately, when I do my A levels, I just simply got 3 passes for my A levels. And when I just go for an college for engineering, I stuck myself. I couldn't complete. So honestly, I just went to a college that I can. Capable of doing software engineering, which is at Indy College. I did my foundation again since my the results were damn low and I could enter a proper university with a proper education. So that's why I just entered Indy College and I did my foundation level and I finished my, I started doing my degree at UOW Computer Science and I did the Software Engineering and Network DESS, like Digital Security Systems, which is a double major degree and which is giving you capable of understanding both network and software. So I have completed my degree, that's why I'm here to do I just gave you the resume to get this job. This is myself.
So let's say I give you a position as a manager in this company. So what kind of actions that you want to do to improve this company?
Okay. First thing I would like to do is a research in this company before I just simply go and sit down in a manager position. I just go inside your company and I will be checking everything out there and I've learned what is that is going on, what tradition you are following, what working culture you are following. Because let's say I just simply go and sit down in a manager post and I don't know what work culture is going on your company, it will affect myself. So I take that sometimes around like 1 day or 2 days to go and understand the culture, like what's happening to the sales. What's happening to the HR department, everything I will be learning. Let's say I go to the sales team. Sales team like, okay, your sales is going down. What is the precautions you are taking over? Purchasing team, why you are purchasing so much of products? Or why you are purchasing such low products? I will be analyzing every single thing and become a good management skills. And I will be make a report. So each analyze I will be keeping in my fingertips. So let's say if got any problem in a department, is that I'm there, will be taking in charge, I will be doing my job correctly, so it will be there will be no issues at all. So if you give me these positions to me, I will be analyze everything, each of them, any problem you will be asking. I could have answered the questions. That's a perfect question. That's why I wanted to become a manager.
Okay. Answers. Okay, so let's move to more relaxing
questions.
May I know what you are supposed to do in your free time?
Okay. Free time, I'm honestly, I'm hanging out with my friends because I'm just a foreigner. And I'm alone, so there should be a friend of friends should be there to take care of me. So around 4 to 5 Sri Lankans over here. Mm-hmm. So we just go outside, just have some fun, play cricket, and like sometimes honestly takes up years.
So. Okay, let's discuss what that you're gonna feel in a work situation. Okay. Let's say when you have your work, how can you handle this pressure in your company?
Okay, this is a situation. When you come pressure, I don't wanna go over and panic like myself and gonna tears out. So what I'm gonna do is I just concentrate what is happening on my situation. What is the problem is there? I just think I take some. It doesn't take like hours to do a precaution. I just take some time. I will be handling all the pressures one by one and just finish it off. Like pressure comes every day. If you go for college life also, pressure comes every day. But it's better to handle this like being quiet, being yourself, and be yourself confident, be strong, and just do it. Just do it. That's my policy.
Just do it. That's great. Okay. Have you ever think about career plans in your life or business ideas?
Okay. Honestly, myself, I did a business over in my country. When I do businesses, I feel like frustration. Not frustration, it's like you have to have more responsibility where you don't have a single time to spend fun. Why I chose this job is I do my work, I complete all my works Monday to Saturday. Monday to Saturday, I just being a good profession, I just do all my jobs done. That helps the company to become a better man. Then I go and spend one day, which is Sunday. Sunday is all day for me. So that's why I choose a job, because I don't have a career plan like just to have a business over there, put investment, become so stressed, increase my sales, I have to check my employees, employee never turn up for work, everything, a single thing I have to take it up. If I go, if you leave me this job, I just get the money which you are giving as a job. I do work for you. I work, complete my work. I become a good representative from you. I do all my works. Then I can become a general manager from career above and like after I have have progress on my job level, right? So you will be giving my progress level because I do my job. But rather than that, I don't have any business plan at all.
Okay. I think that's it for today. It's a very interesting interview. So thank you for taking this into consideration.
Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Just come in.
Hello, sir.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. So this will be my resume.
Okay.
Yeah,
hello. Okay. Introduce yourself.
Okay. So my name is John Rufelin, and I am a graduate from URW University from computer science major. And from this major, actually, first time I had no intention to have this major. I really have a blank idea for which course that I should take in my previous year. I ever thought to become a doctor, and in the end, just like spin very quick, and in the end, I just land in this computer science, and I found it very interesting, and I can found really a lot of things that I learned. And This kind of knowledge is a things that I can take it until a long term, because technology is keep on developing. So yeah, this is what I'm sitting here.
So okay. Can you tell me about doing the school life, because you told me about your university life. Can I know about your school life?
My school life, you mean university?
No, the school life, SPM.
So actually, I'm a foreigner, so I'm from Indonesia, and I didn't pass to like O levels or A levels something. So from my school, high school, I can get straight to the degree. So I can just explain what I feel when I was at high school. So actually, at my high school, I don't have really not concentrate enough to my studies. So, but mostly I enjoy to like handle like a like retreat someday. So bring groups of students to go somewhere else to go and have a retreat or something like organization. So I like to organize something in my school. So organize how to manage this event, how to control these students or something like that, because there are a lot of characters in every student's got a different characters, different acts, how to handle them. And to be honest, these things not makes become a priority, but still studies become a priority. And my scores not pretty bad, still high, it's not too bad, it's not too low, too high, and I enjoy my high school a lot.
Okay, that's pretty good, which is true. Can you tell me, what is your extracurricular, like, do you do sports, or do you do, like, anything, like, apart from that, like, you went into a club to organize an event or something like that, do you have anything interesting like that?
Actually, I'm interesting a lot at sports, especially futsal, because I really like sports. And yeah, in case of that, I also like football. That makes them quite similar, just the difference of maybe the players to play inside. And unfortunately, I didn't join the extracurricular in my high school that time because in my previous time of study, in the afternoon, I used to have some tuitions to improve myself in my study. So, and in that extracurricular, it happens in the afternoon, so I couldn't join that. And also, there are also like music extracurricular, and I like music. I'm a drum player, I'm a drummer, and I like to compose music as well. But again, I can't join because of the time, because of the situation that make me difficult to join the club or soccer like that. But in our organization, I joined, in my country we call it OSIS. So it's an organization for to handle whole secondary students or whole of high school students. So I joined that organization for probably 2 years, and from that experience I really got something that maybe for me in the future, so I can use it to handle my employees maybe in the future.
Pretty good, right? Okay, I'm hiring as you a manager. Okay, I just let me imagine, like, I give you this position, what you will be doing, like, what action you will take?
Okay, as a manager, it's not a easy, every job is not an easy job, easy things to handle. So, I'm a critical person, and I'm a very hardworking person, and also very careful for doing things. So I'm very intense of even a small kind of work. So as a manager, I have to know the situation of my company. So I have to know what's my employer do, and what my employer feels, because if my employer cannot enjoy the work, the company cannot work properly as well. And I have to go straight into the situation as well. So not just like sitting, do nothing, or just like sign things and like, just do the easy thing, but I have to go inside and go, I have to involve myself so I can know the situation, so I can know what things that I should do to improve, and also I have to help the company to grow.
Okay. Let's say I just ask you a simple question. It is based on your own opinion. Let's say a sales person was stolen all the money, like stolen all the money from the sales department and he ran away. What actions do you take as a manager?
Well, that's things that makes the company grow, let's say. But these things can be handled, but it needs to be finished maybe in a long term plan. So let's say that person stole the money from the company. I would probably, for the sake of the law, maybe I will report to the police, because this thing is not what the salesman took is not a small amount of money. He or she took a lot, which is can make the company as it grow. So I would report it to the police and explain everything, the situation, and I will forgive the person, but he or she should deserve the consequences.
That's a good proof. Now, let's say your academy, everything was fine, you want to become a doctor and you become a computer science student, okay, or industry. Let's say one time there is no progress at my company, would you leave the job or would you stay in the job?
It depends. In the company, there's still a chance to rebuild, or let's say to re-establish the company. If there's a chance, I would like to stay in the company and find a solution how to solve the problem and how to get that company back to the business. And of course, to fulfill that, I need my colleagues or what that I trust a lot to improve and to fix the company. And if the company cannot improve, it cannot be fixed anymore, I think I will leave to find a better company to work.
Okay, that's a good idea.